Okey diyoruz. En son ne oldu? Bundan önceki bölüm iki temel olaydan oluşuyor. İlkinde Claude Fisher'ı da çalıştı. İkincisinde de Elodie'nin ilk dersine katıldılar. İlk kısım işte o güne başladı. Böyle Elodie'nin dersin heyecanıyla direkt Elodie'nin dersi gelse de işte ders dinlesek modundaydı ama Elodie'nin dersi işte öğlene kadar olmuyordu falan. Ama Kvot'un işte o boş zamanını değerlendirmesi lazım. Çünkü borcu var. Devi'ye cercürt diyoruz. Fisher'ye gitti. Tam çalışmaya başlayacaktı. Kilvin bunu çağırdı. Kilvin'in yanına gitti. İşte kızın ya da kadının emin değilim. Birisi İşte seni tanımlamış uşaklardan birine, kırmızı saçlı cırtçuk birini arıyorum. İşte o bana büyü yaptı. Bana büyü yapan kırmızı saçlı cırtçuk birini arıyorum diye birini arıyormuş. Bir kadın diyorlar ama göreceksiniz daha sonra aslında yaşı ufak olan birisi, kadın diyesim gelmiyor onun için. Neyse diyor. İşte sen insanlara büyü mü satıyorsun falan yaptı Kilvin böyle. Öyle bir şey yok falan yaptı. Kvot bilmiyorum hani kim olabilir o kadın, onu da bilmiyorum falan. Sonra işte ne oldu? Kilvin'e kanıtladı gibi oldu. Ben işte eğer millete yalandan büyü yapıp satıyor olsaydım bu derece eski tişört cırt giymezdim falan yaptı. Bunları duyunca Kilvin yumuşadı, ikna oldu diyoruz. Sonra Kvot'u saldı. Sonra Elodie'nin dersine geliyoruz. 7 kişi var sınıfta. Biri Kvot, birisi ilk kitapta Exodal'ın dersinde ölümüne alar dövüş yaptıkları uşak Fenton. Üçüncüsü Fela. Diğer 4 kişi böyle şu ana kadar duymadığımız tipler. Elodie'nin derse geç geldi. Derste enteresan konular hakkında konuştu ama güzel şeyler var bence. Hani şeyi sevdiğim, istediğimi fark ettim. Hani şimdi birkaç Elodin dersi daha okuyalım da Elodin bize değişik değişik şeyler anlatsın falan oldum böyle. Hani ben de Kvot'la beraber merakla beklemeye başladığımı hissediyorum. Elodin'in derslerinin olduğu bölümleri diyoruz. Onun dışında bunlara 20 tane falan kitap ismi yazdı. Bu kitapları Archive'da keşfedip bulacaksınız. Bunlardan bir tanesini okuyacaksınız. Diğerlerine de bir göz gezdirin gibi bir şey dedi sanırım. Diğer ders konuşacağız falan demedi ama büyük ihtimal konuşacaklar diyoruz. Chapter 13, The Hunt. Determined to make a good showing of myself in Elodie's class. I tracked down Willem and negotiated an exchange of future drinks for his help navigating the archives. Elodie'nin gözüne niye girmeye çalışıyorsun? Elodie'nin gözüne girmek ne demek amık diyoruz. We made our way through the cobbled streets of the university together. The wind gusting as the huge windowless shape of the archives loomed above us across the courtyard. The words Warfella and Renata Moriae were chiseled into the stone above the massive stone doors. As we came closer, I realized my hands were sweaty. You're then lady, hold on for a second, I said as I stopped walking. You raised an eyebrow at me. I am nervous as any whore, I said. Just give me a moment. You said Lauren lifted his band 2 days ago, William said. I thought you'd be inside as soon as you had permission. I was waiting for them to update the ledgers. I wiped my damn hands on my shirt. I know something's going to happen, I said anxiously. My name won't be in the book, but Ambrose will be at the desk, and I will have some sort of relapse from that plum drug and end up kneeling on his throat and screaming. I like to see that, we said, but Ambrose doesn't work today. That's something, I admitted, relaxing a bit. I pointed to the words above the door. Do you know what that means? We glanced up. The desire for knowledge shapes a man, he said, or something close to that. Bir dakika. Buna dair teoriler vardı. Onları hatırlayıp geliyor. He said, or something close to that. I like that. I took a deep breath. Right, let's go. I pulled open the huge stone doors and entered a small antechamber. Then we tugged open the inner doors and we stepped into the entry hall. In the middle of the room was a huge wooden desk with several large Letterbox, ledgers, open the top, it. Several imposing doors led off in different directions. Bella sat behind the desk, her curling hair pulled back into a tail. The red light from the sympathy lamps made her look different, but no less pretty. She smiled. Hello, fella, I said, trying not to sound as nervous as I felt. I heard I am back in Lauren's good books. Could you check for me? She nodded and began to flip through the ledger in front of her. Her face brightened and she pointed. Her expression went dark. I felt a sinking sensation in my stomach. What is it? I asked. Is something wrong? No, she said, nothing's wrong. You look like something's wrong, Will grumbled. What does it say? Pelle stated, let's spin the book around so we could read it. Quote, a Leiden son, red-haired, fair-complected, young. Written next to this in the margin in a different script were the words, Ruh bastard. I grinned at her, correct on all accounts. Can I go in? She nodded. Do you need lamps? She asked, opening a drawer. I do, Will said, already writing his name in a separate ledger. I got my own, I said, pulling my small lamp from a pocket of my cloak. Pelle opened the admittance ledger and signed us in. My hand shook as I wrote, skittering the pen's nib embarrassingly, so it flicked ink across the page. Pelle blotted it away and closed the book. She smiled up at me. Welcome back, she said. Let William lead the way through the stakes and did my best to look properly amazed. It wasn't a hard part to play. I had access to the archives for some time. I'd been forced to creep around like a thief. I had kept my lamp on its dimmest setting and avoided the main hallways for fear of accidentally running into someone. Charles covered every bit of the stone walls. Some hallways were broad and open with high ceilings, while others formed narrow lanes barely wide enough for two people to pass if they both turned sideways. The air was heavy with the smell of leather and dust, of old parchment and binding glue. It smelled of secrets. William led me through twisting shelves, up some stairs and through a long, wide hallway lined with books bound, all in identical red leather. Finally, we came to a door with dim red light showing around the edges. There are rooms set aside for private study, William said softly, reading halls. Sim and I used this one a lot. Not many people know about it. Will knocked briefly on the door before he opened it to reveal a windowless room barely larger than the table and chairs it contained. Sim sat at the table, the red light of his sympathy lamp making his face look ruddier than usual. His eyes grew wide when he saw me. Quote, what are you doing in here? He turned to William horrified. What is he doing in here? Lauren lifted his band, William said. Our young boy has a reading list. He's planning his first book hunt. Congratulations, Sim beamed at me. Can I have? I'm falling asleep here. He held out his hand. Okay, devam edeceğiz. Kendinize iyi bakın. Görüşürüz.